either is the church, as one everyone of us is looking unto that Jesus Christ has given to us, that by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, it will not fall. He will not disappoint Jesus Christ. He will not disappoint himself. He will not disappoint his family. He will not disappoint his children. That anything that we take away Jesus Christ from him, God will take him from that particular thing in Jesus' name. That the grace of the Lord will continue to be sufficient for him. That God will continue to lead him. That in his place of work, as a leader, all weapons that will stand against him, God will cut them down in Jesus' name. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, all his vision, physically, materially, spiritually, he will achieve them in Jesus' name. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, he will lead many as he can, to the extent that he will say no. God, as he wants to do more, God will guide them in Jesus' name. He will not fail. His hand will continue to be prospered. His life will continue to be prospered. And the grace of the Lord will continue to be upon him with all things that belong unto him. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Almighty Father, we cannot count, but we just want to say thank you for how you have started with him, for where you are with him, for where you are taking him to. Father, on his behalf, I know he humbled himself before you. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, all his tears, you will wipe away in Jesus' name. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you that call him, in all around, when I mean all around, spiritually, physically, materially, you will not leave him in glory in Jesus' name. I do not know you. Lord, at the end of his race, will not be his portion in the name of Jesus Christ. He has carried the load, but in all areas, I don't want to be mentioning, so that we not be like we turn him to idol. But Almighty Father, to whom the praises belong to, we need to, as you told us. Almighty Father, we pray, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we think with the load, he will not fall in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, you will lead him to destination. You will lead him to your glory in the name of Jesus Christ. And anybody that see him, they will see the glory of the Lord upon him in Jesus' name. Those who curse him shall be cursed. Those who pray for him shall be prayed. That shall be prayed for. Those who bless him shall be blessed. And the grace of the Lord will continue to be upon him. Whatever he touch shall be prosper. And the glory of the Lord will continue to fall upon his family, both the nuclear and the extension, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Almighty Father, he has just seen a little. Because I believe the more he moves with you, the more you are going to be glorifying yourself in his life. Almighty Father, this you will do for him. Almighty Father, for everyone of us he is leading, Almighty Father, he will look back at the end and he will say, God, I thank you for this particular person, this particular person. This is where he is. And then he will be able to lay down and say, God, I thank you for using me for this particular person. This will be his portion in Jesus' name. Thank you, O Lord, because you are the Lord and answer prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Once again, the church say, Happy Friday. So we shall listen to Pastor's message. Before then, Brother Stephen still come to be leading people into prayer to engage.
Amen. Let's turn to our feet. This is the moment that we are waiting for. A moment that the Lord God is about to use his servant to speak to us. He has placed his word in the mouth of his servant. And we are going to hear the word of God just the way it is. Pray that the Lord God will prepare your heart, that you will receive this word and be the doer of it. pray that God will open the eyes of your understanding. That as you hear the word, you will understand. As you hear the word will fall in the fertile ground of your heart. That you will meditate on this word and be the doer of it. Pray and say, Lord, that word that you have for me, I receive it this hour. I have come here. Say, I don't want to go home without taking something home. Say, Lord, fill me. I want to go home with something tangible. I want to live here with a difference. Let the word that I'm about to hear enlighten my understanding. Let it make a difference in my life. Pray unto the Lord.
This is the money of Becca Kariotu.
Marvelous.
One night, Safiana.
Marvelous.
Safiana.
Marvelous.
Safiana Al-Ajabe.
Grace of salvation.
Al-Ajabe no chetu.
Healing, deliverance.
Whatsoever
may be your need. The mighty God, the great God of heaven, through his anointed servant,
going
to give you your heart desire in Jesus' name. We appreciate everyone here, all the men of God and all the people from various religion denominations. You are welcome in Jesus' mighty name.
And
have the honor, the privilege of introducing to you our Father in the Lord, the man of God, the preacher of the gospel, our general superintendent in Deeper Christian Life Ministry, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi, as he comes up now with the power of God to minister the word of God with the anointing. God has been using this morning again. Get ready. The house come. God will use you to bless your soul. Put your hands together for Jesus. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you. Everybody, praise the Lord. Lafia Nansara was to it. I said, praise the Lord. It's a special day. Special time. I pray that the specialty of today will come upon your life in Jesus' name. It's our Sunday worship service. And we're taking your faces to all over the world. It's the last Sunday of the month. Because of that, we're taking this service to the rest of the world. If your faces are bowed and ruined and frowning, we'll take that frowning face from Nazarawa to everywhere. If you are actually disturbing the preaching, and you wave your hand and you shout while I'm preaching, we'll take your waving and your shouting to the rest of the set. Let's lose our stage.
Idan kuna damun mu kuna surutu kuna daga hannu sayin da nake wazi haka zamu dauka mu nuna mu duniya gabaki dai su ce wannan daga jahar Nasarawa ne.
If you sit patiently and you listen to the word of God, and the word of God penetrates your heart and your life, and there is a change and transformation, we see a quiet church, an orderly church, a church under the authority of the word of God, will take that to the rest of the world too.
idan kuka zauna suru kuka saurari maganan Allah kuka kasa kunne kuka ji wazin da za a yi muku ecclesia wanda take karkashin ikon na Allah alqadiru haka zamu dauki wannan sako mu kai mu duniya gaba
ɗaya. And all the miracles that will happen here,
duka al'ajibi da za su faru a nan gurin,
you will see,
za ku gani,
I will see,
ni ma zan gani,
the rest of the world will see,
duniya gaba ki daya za
su gani. Somebody is getting ready for blessing today,
wani yana shiri domin
alƙarku a yau. Somebody wants this to be a morning of miracles,
wani na so wannan ya zama
sabuwar
al'ajibi na
musamman, wonderful miracle,
al'ajibi mai girma,
unforgettable miracle in your life,
wanda ba za ku iya manta ba a rayuwar
ku. What is the person I'm talking to
here? Wani ne nake magana da shi?
Father will thank you today,
Allah alƙadiru mun gode maka
yau,
mun dauka ka
suna, we glorify you,
mun girmama ka,
we know you are mighty God,
san ka Allah ne alƙadiru,
love your people,
kana kaunar jama'a,
and what we know,
mun sani,
the rock of ages we can stand on,
kai ne dutse na tsara da ki zamu iya
tsaya, for salvation,
domin ceto,
for healing,
domin warkarwa,
for deliverance,
domin yanci,
we need you Lord,
you are buƙatar
ka, come my children in the midst of your people in Jesus name,
ka zo da iko tsakanin jama'a ka cikin sunan Yesu.
The pages of the scriptures
to people,
and
then
the power of the word, the wonder of the world, and the miracle in the message, come upon every soul in Jesus' name. Thank you, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. And Nazarawa State says amen.
Jama'an jahar Nasarawa suka ce amin.
You can sit down.
Nagode Allah shi albarkace ku bari
ku dauki. I'm looking at Ezekiel chapter 36.
Ina duba Ezekiel sura 36.
Ezekiel chapter 36.
Ezekiel 36.
And I'm reading from verse 11.
Daga ayan nan ta 11.
By the way, as you look at this chapter of Ezekiel.
Yadda kuka duba wannan aya na Ezekiel.
Ezekiel an evangelist.
Ezekiel mai bishara
ne. Ezekiel a watchman.
Ezekiel mai lura.
Ezekiel a preacher.
Ezekiel mai wa'azi.
Ezekiel a prophet.
Ezekiel a nabi.
Ezekiel a shepherd.
Ezekiel makiyayi.
Ezekiel having the burden of a whole nation at heart.
Ezekiel wanda ke dauki nauyin kaya na al'umma.
Ezekiel having the burden of an individual at heart.
Sani wanda ke daukan dawainiyar duniya
gaba ɗaya. Ezekiel having the burden of your family at heart.
Yana dauki dawainiyar iyali gaba ɗaya.
As you look at Ezekiel.
Yadda kuka dubi Ezekiel.
It shows us the promise of God.
Ya nuna maka alƙawarin Allah.
As you look at Ezekiel.
Yadda kuka duba Ezekiel.
It shows us the plan of God.
Ya nuna mana shirin Allah.
As you look at Ezekiel.
Yadda kuka duba Ezekiel.
It shows us the covenant of God.
Ya nuna mana alƙawarin Allah.
And because he's talking about the plan of God.
Domin yana magana akan shirin Allah.
And the purpose of God.
Da nufin Allah.
And the power of God.
Da ikon Allah.
He gives us the promise of God.
Ya ba mu alƙawarin Allah.
For you as an individual today,
akai da kanka yau,
and for you as a family today,
da kuma iyali gabaki daya,
and for those of us who represent the whole state,
mu kuma da muke wakiltar jihar gabaki daya,
here is Ezekiel the watchman,
wannan shine Ezekiel
the lura, here is Ezekiel the prophet,
wannan Ezekiel annabi,
he wants to connect you,
yana so ya hada ku,
with your miracle today,
al'ajibin ku a wannan
rana, wannan he wants to connect you,
yana so ya hada ku,
with the power of God today,
da ikon Allah a yau,
it's coming,
yana zuwa,
I said it's coming,
yace yana zuwa,
and it will get your family in Jesus name,
zo ga iyalanku a cikin sunan Yesu,
and you will see in this chapter I'm reading to you,
za ku duba inda zamu yi karatu,
God said I will,
yadda Allah yace zani,
when heaven says I will,
idan sammai suka ce zamu yi,
there is no one on earth that can stop him,
ba wannan mutumi a fuskan duniya a wannan zai hana
shi, when God says I will,
idan Allah yace zan yi,
there is no personality in hell that can stop him,
ba wani iko cikin jahannama wanda zai hana,
he says he will do something in your life,
yace zai yi wani abu cikin rayuwarku,
I said he will do something in your life,
yace zai yi wani abu a cikin rayuwarku,
what he said he will do, he will do,
abinda yace zai yi za ya yi,
Ezekiel 36 verse 11,
Ezekiel 36 ayan nan ta
sa, and I will multiply upon you man and beast,
zan kuma yawaita muku mutun da dabbobi.
I shall increase and bring fruit.
Za ku karu ku yaya.
And I will settle you after your old estate.
Insa ayi muku zama cikin ku bisa ga misalin
kanakin da. I will do better unto you than at your beginnings.
Har ma in yi muku albarka wanda ta fi ta farko.
I thought somebody there will say amen.
Ina ce ko za ku ce amen.
And you shall know that I am the Lord.
Zaku sa kankance ku a ni ne ubangiji.
God says he'll do something.
Allah yace zai yi wani abu.
And he says he will so do it.
Yace zai kuwa yi shi.
That you will know.
Kuma za ku sani.
In your heart.
A cikin zuciya.
He will do something.
Zai yi wani abu.
He will do it in your soul.
Zai yi shi cikin zuciyarku.
That you will know I am the Lord.
Zaku sani ni ne ubangiji.
And then he uses one word there. He says I will multiply.
Ye amfani da wata kalma cewa zan hayayyafa ku.
Multiplication of blessing.
Hayayyafawa na albarka.
Multiplication of miracle.
Hayayyafawa na albarka.
Multiplication of joy.
Hayayyafawa na farin ciki.
Multiplication of satisfaction.
Hayayyafawa na gamsuwa.
Multiplication of blessing.
Hayayyafawa na albarka.
Today is your day.
Wannan rana domin ku ne.
I said today is your day.
Wannan rana domin ku ne.
In that verse of scripture.
Wannan aya ta littafi.
It speaks about the fruit.
Yayi magana game da yaya.
He says then he will do better things for you today than at your beginning.
Yace har ma zan yi muku albarka wanda ta fita da.
Better. Everybody shout better.
Kowa yace mafi kyau.
Better things are coming your way.
Abubuwa masu kyau na zuwa gare
ku. And now Ezekiel tells us.
Ezekiel ya sake gaya mana.
When you read these verses you are surprised.
Idan kuka karanta za ku yi mamaki.
Because he say I'm looking for this blessing.
Yace ina bukatar wannan albarka. Ina bukatar wannan albarka.
I'm searching for this miracle.
Ina neman wannan mu'ajiza.
I'm running after this miracle.
Ina neman wannan al'ajabi.
Ezekiel takes us by surprise.
Sai Ezekiel ya ba mu mamaki.
He's going to talk about the mother of all miracles.
Sai yi magana game da al'ajabi mafi
girma. He's going to talk about the foundation of all miracles.
Yana so yi magana game da farko na al'ajabi.
He's going to talk about the source of all miracles.
Yana so yi magana game da mafarin dukkan al'ajabi.
He's going to talk about the generator. Said, I'm sure you know that, what generates electricity. It's not going to talk about the generating set of miracles in your life.
Yana so yayi magana da inji mai kawo wuta game da wato al'ajabai a rayuwanku.
And so it takes us to verse 25.
Ya komar da mu ayan nan ta 25.
Verse 25.
Aya ta 25.
Will I sprinkle clean water upon you and you shall be clean.
Sa'annan zan yayyafa muku ruwa mai tsafta za ku tsafta.
It says from all your field vineyards and from all your idols will I cleanse you.
Daga cikin dukan kazanta da dukan gumakan ku zan tsarkake.
I want you to understand Ezekiel.
Ina so ku gane abin da Ezekiel ke faɗa.
You want healing.
Kuna son warkaswa.
What if you have healing?
Ya ce ku samu warkaswa. Sai ba komai.
No water to bath.
Ba ruwa da za ku yi wanka.
No water to clean up.
Ba ruwan da za ku share kanku.
No water to wash your mouth.
Ba ruwan da za ku kurkure baki.
No water to drink.
Ba ruwan da za ku sha.
I am healed.
Na samu warkaswa.
There is no water.
Ba ruwa.
For a week, for a month, for a year.
Wato a mako, a wata, a shekara.
I'm going to sprinkle clean water upon you.
Yace zan hayayyafa muku ruwa mai tsafta.
And ye shall be clean.
Za ku samu tsaftacewa.
From all your idols I will cleanse you.
Daga dukkan gumakan ku zan tsaftace ku.
The origin of miracles.
Wannan ita ce al'ajabi na farko.
The foundation of miracles.
Ita ce al'ajabi mafi
girma. The source of miracles.
Ita ce al'ajabi mafi girma.
The heavenly generator of miracles.
Ita ce wato al'ajabi mai zuwa daga samaniya. Ruwa.
We cannot deal without that.
Ba za mu iya rayuwa ba tare da ruwa ba.
Verse 26.
Ku koma ayan nan ta 26.
A new heart will I give you.
Sabuwar zuciya kuma zan ba
ku. A new spirit will I also give you.
Sabon ruhu kuma zan sa a cikin ku.
And I'll put that within you.
Daga cikin cikin ku.
I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh.
Zan cire daga cikin zuciya
ku na dutse. And I will give you a heart of flesh.
Zan ba ku zuciya mai taushi.
Ezekiel, can you explain what you are saying?
Ezekiel, za ka iya mana bayanin abin da kake faɗa?
Somebody needs a miracle because of something working in in the head. But he has a bad heart. The heart is not sending the blood of life into every part of the body. Somebody says, I have a problem in my finger. And I need a miracle there. And the seeker said, yes, I understand. Your heart is not functioning well. The heart is the center of your life. Your heart is gone, you are gone. If you don't have a good functioning heart, whatever you say you have, everything will go down the drain. Very important, water. Very important, your heart.
Verse 27.
And I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes. And you shall keep my judgments and do them. Here comes now the spirit. Do you remember when God created man? The form was there. The physical was there. It was like a lump of clay. Until the Almighty God breathed the spirit into man. And man became a living soul. And Ezekiel reminds you.
Says,
yes, I know what you think you want. But you know, you are carcass without the spirit. You're just a lump of clay without the spirit. And so he says important things. Number one, the water. Number two, the heart. Number three, the spirit. And he say, I'll do that for you. Is the mother of all miracles.
Is
the origin of all miracles.
Is
the generator of all miracles.
Is
the fountain of all miracles.
It
is the seed that brings all other miracles in your life. I'm speaking to you today on this important subject. The promise of an indispensable miracle. Water, the heart,
Zuchia,
the spirit.
Uruhu.
And when you have that, every other thing will follow. Today, he will save your soul. I'm talking to somebody there. I said, today, he will save your soul. And the Lord will take the water of heaven.
He
will wash you. Somebody there said, he will cleanse you. Somebody there said, he will purge you. Somebody there, he will purify you.
Yes,
take that water and it will cleanse your soul.
Say, don't you want to
and then he'll put a new heart in you.
Yes,
that thing that is swollen there. Think like stone inside there. The heart of stone. God is going to perform operation upon you today. He will take out that stony heart. That stubborn heart. That rebellious heart. That dangerous heart. The heart that leads a person into hell.
He
will take that away from you, and he will give you a submissive heart, a sanctified heart, a holy heart. He will put a heart of flesh in you, and then the spirit of God, the presence of God, the power of God will come upon your life today. By the time God releases you to go back home this afternoon, I see a new man there. I see a new woman there. Because power from on high will come upon your life today in Jesus' name. The promise of an indispensable miracle.
Alƙawarina al'ajibi mai mahimmanci sosai.
We're looking at three things.
Zamu raba jawabi a ƙasa
biyu. Number one, the provision of salvation.
Na farko tanidi domin ceto.
The provision of salvation.
Tanidi domin ceto.
Number two,
na biyu,
the purity through sanctification.
Tsarkakewa ta wurin tsaftacewa.
That's what he said he will do.
Abin da yace zai aikata kenan.
Is the base.
Wannan shine rayi.
He said that is the foundation.
Wannan shine mafari.
He said that is the springboard from which you launch into all the miracles in your life.
Wannan shine mafari inda zaka shiga kowace al'ajibi a rayuwarka.
The purity through sanctification.
Tsaftacewa ta wurin tsarkakewa.
And then number three.
Sannan na uku.
The pouring out of the spirit.
Zubowa na ruhu mai tsarki.
The pouring out of the spirit.
Zubowa na ruhu mai tsarki.
Section one, two, three. Those are pillars.
And
once you have those pillars in place,
then
we can build whatever we want to build.
And
glory will come from on high upon your life. Power will come up from on high upon your life. Unforgettable. Somebody there said unforgettable. That unforgettable scene is happening to you today. Come back now. We're looking at verse 25. And I'm looking at the provision of salvation. Ezekiel chapter 36 and in verse 25. It says, then will I speak unclean water upon you. Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you. That's what then is a word of timing. Then I will do that. This comes, then this will come. You come to the Lord. If you stay far away from Christ, if you stay far away from the Almighty God, if you stay far away from the invitation he's giving you, you cannot sprinkle the water on you. He cannot cleanse you. He cannot forgive you. He cannot change your life. But he says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, then you come. Then after that, will I sprinkle clean water upon you? He says, repent. Let the sinner turn from his way. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call your body what is near. Let the wicked forsake his way. And your righteous man is
told.
If you do that, then will I sprinkle clean water upon you. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and seek my face and pray and turn from their wicked ways, I will forgive them. After you've done that, then when I speak clean water upon you, and you shall be clean. That's why he's calling you, and he wants you to look at your life, all the cleanness in your life, all the filthiness in your life, and you say, Lord, I come. Lord, I turn. Lord, I repent. I want to repent sincerely from the depths of your heart. He will sprinkle clean water upon you. You shall be clean. Somebody there, you shall be clean. Somebody there said, you shall be clean. Your heart will be clean. Your mind will be clean. Your thoughts will be clean. Your actions will be clean. That's the promise of God. I will sprinkle clean water upon you. And then you from the inside, your very life, and everything around you, he says, ye shall be clean. And then he tells us another thing. He says, as you come, you have an idol.
And
he says, if you will present that idol,
take
that idol,
destroy
that idol,
throw
away that idol.
There are
visible idols
of
stone, of money, of gold,
of
silver.
He says
he wants to cleanse you from all your idols.
And
you need to present those idols before the Lord.
There
are invisible idols.
It's
in your
heart.
Invisible idols. The idol of self, the idol of covetousness, the idol of evil. And he says, if you bring that invisible idol in the presence of the Lord,
he says,
and I will cleanse you from all your idols. The idol of pride, the idol of rebellion.
And
you hold that idol as the number one thing in your life.
Since
then, if you bring that idol, you surrender that idol and you give that idol unto the Lord.
He
says, I will cleanse you from all your filthiness, your filthy language, your filthy lifestyle, your filthy relationship, and your filthy action.
And
your idols, I will cleanse you. Look at that verse again, verse
25.
Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you.
And
this from the ordinary water. This one is coming from heaven. This is not the ordinary water. This one is coming from the throne of God. And he says, I'm going to sprinkle that water upon you. Somebody there is a candidate of the sprinkling today.
I said,
somebody there is a candidate of the sprinkling today. And then he says, I'll cleanse you from all your filthiness. You see three things here. Number one, cleansing with regeneration. Cleansing with regeneration. Regeneration. He wants to remake you, remold you, recreate you. He wants to reform you and refashion you. And that is the regeneration. And it comes with the washing of water by the word. And it comes with the cleansing of the blood of Jesus. Wash my sins away. For the blood of Jesus. What can make me clean and whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. All the precious flow coming from the very throne of God. That's why David prayed and said, wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. Regeneration.
Abantawa.
A washing.
Wankewa.
A cleansing.
Abantawa.
A purifying.
Abantawa.
A transformation.
Abantawa.
Cleansing with regeneration.
Abantawa.
I'm reading to you from Titus chapter
3.
Titus chapter 3.
Titus.
And I'm reading here from verse 5. Not by the works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us. Look at this, by the washing of regeneration. By the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost as you come to the Lord and you confess, Lord, I know I'm a sinner. I present myself before you. Lord, I know I am dirty. My sins make me dirty. And I come for washing. I come for cleansing. The cleansing cleansing of the regeneration of the Lord himself. And he cleanses you. And he washes you. It will happen today. I said it will happen today. Am I talking to somebody there? I said it will happen today. We're looking at 1 John chapter 1. 1 John chapter 1. I'm looking at verse 7. But if we walk in the light, no more darkness of occultism, no more darkness of secret sinning. You come out in the open. Lord, here I come. I am coming for the cleansing. I am coming for the washing. I am coming for the change of heart. I am coming for the change of life. If we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. You see what he wants to do. Number one is the cleansing with regeneration.
As
cooking water upon you, and you shall be clean. From all your filthiness, from all your idols, will I cleanse you. Number two is the clothing with righteousness. With righteousness. When a child is born, you wash the child, you cleanse the child, you take all that filthiness away, but you don't leave the child like that. You close the child, and this is what the Lord is talking about. You come, you present yourself before the Lord. He washes you. He cleanses you. He forgives your sin. He changes your life. And he clothes you with righteousness. He clothes you with righteousness. There's a clothing today. And it's for you. I said it's for you. Righteousness will come upon your life. Look at Psalm 132. Psalm 132. Meaning from verse 9. Let thy priest be clothed with righteousness, and thy saints shall shout with joy. Your priest clothed with righteousness. And then he says, you'll shout with joy. Come to verse 9:8:16. I will also close her priest with salvation. And I say, she'll shout for joy. As you look at those two verses, there are two things there. The clothing of salvation and the clothing of righteousness. And he wants to do that for you today. Otherwise, you say, I'm a Christian. Actually, what you mean is, I'm a church goer. I'm a Christian. Actually, what you mean is, I was baptized and as infant, and he gave me the name Stephen. I am a Christian. What you mean is, I bear the name Josephine. But, you know, you're naked without salvation. And the devil can see your nakedness without salvation. And the demons can see your nakedness without salvation. I'm a Christian. What you mean is, I belong to this denomination. Even though you belong to this denomination, you're naked. And the Lord said, when you come, I will wash you, I will cleanse you, and I will clothe you. Look up here. Which if you get healed, and then you are walking the streets naked? What if you get a miracle, and the foundation of miracle, the cleansing and the clothing? The man says, praise the Lord, my headache is gone. Praise the Lord, I was lame, now I can walk. And the man is walking the street naked. The nakedness will destroy the impact and the effect of the miracle. That's why the Lord is saying, number one, I'm going to cleanse you. Number two, I'm going to close you. There is the cleansing of regeneration. And there is the clothing with righteousness. And then cleaving to the Redeemer. Cleaving to the Redeemer. You know, there are some people that say, yes, I come. And they come and they get healed. But they are not cleaving to Christ, the Redeemer, the Healer, the Deliverer. And because you are detached from the Lord Jesus Christ, you are detached, therefore you can be attached. The thing that keeps a miracle, and the thing that keeps a healing, and the thing that keeps your redemption, is your cleaving, attachment to the Redeemer. And when your eyes are opened, you keep on following Christ. You rise up from your lameness, you keep on following Christ. And your stomach problem is gone, you keep on following Christ. But you know, you come, and after that you are detached. After that you are alone. After that the devil doesn't see any protection around you. You get healed in the morning, he attacks you in the evening. But if you allow the Lord to do his work today, I'll say, number one, I am cleansed. Number two, I am closed. Number three, I am cleaving unto Christ. The devil will not find an inroad into your life anymore. To Nasrawa State, I said, the devil will not find inroad in your life anymore in Jesus' name. Cleansed by the blood of the Lamb. Closed by the righteousness of Christ. And cleaving unto the Redeemer. Acts of the Apostles chapter 11. Acts of the Apostles chapter 11. And I'm reading from verse 23. Acts chapter 11 verse 23. Look at this. When he came and had seen the grace of God, he was glad, and he exhorted them all that with purpose of heart they will cleave unto the Lord. What decision and determination, with decision and devotion, dedication, with consecration and commitment, you make up your mind, I know the Lord, I'll stay with the Lord. That's the secret of the continuous miracle in your life. It's the secret of power unlimited, power unceasing, power unstoppable. I will stay with the Lord. Somebody there, I will stay with the Lord. Somebody that want to hear Nasarawa voice, I will stay with the Lord. He encouraged them. He exhorted them. And he told them what they must do. You must cleave unto the Lord. That's what makes that first pillar of miracle, stand firm. The provision of salvation, and he's doing that for you today. I said he's doing that for you today. You make up your mind. You say, yes, I want to have Jesus as my Savior. I want to take him as my Redeemer. I come to him. I will continue with him. I cleave unto him. I will never leave him. And he will never leave you. He'll stay by you, stay with you through to the end in Jesus' name. Let's come back to Ezekiel. Well, we must make the pillars, establish the pillars one after the other. Ezekiel chapter 36. I'm reading now from verse 26. Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 26. A new heart also will I give you. Underline that word also. Also. That means I've done the first one. I'm going to do the second one. I'm sure you've met a lot of people who talk about being born again. Salvation, salvation. I've confessed my sins to Christ. He has forgiven me. He has taken away my sin. Praise the Lord, I am saved. And I will say, what else? Oh, he says, I don't know anything else. I am saved. You see, verse 25 is salvation. And then in verse 26, it says, this is a different, distinct, subsequent experience of the Christian life. It says, also, I'm going to do another thing. A new heart also will I give you. You. Who is he talking about? You. Who is he talking about? I said you. Who is he talking about? Is he talking to you? Why are you not sanctified? Why are you not made holy? What is it every time you hear about holiness? I want healing, not holiness. He says, a new heart also will I give unto you. He says, when I do the first one, you cannot stand on one leg. I must do the second one. A new heart also will I give unto you. And then he tells us, and he says, a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. It's talking about purity through sanctification. Do you see three things then what I read to you now? Number one, the removal of the natural stony heart. The removal of the natural stony heart. We don't go to school to learn stubbornness. It's natural. There is no course of studies or curriculum for rebellion. It is natural. We don't go to primary, secondary, and university to learn to say no to authority. It is natural. It's the stony heart. It's the stubborn heart. It is the selfish heart. It is the self-centered life. And God knows that that will block your way to heaven. But that stony heart that you possess, it's going to bring stubbornness, and it's going to bring self-will, you seek, you are hurting other people, but you are closing the door of heaven against yourself. The Christian life and rebellion, they do not go together. The Christian life and stubbornness do not go together. The Christian life and the rigidity in evil will not go together. That's why it says, a new heart also will I give you. And I will put a new spirit within you. And I will take away the stony heart. The removal of the natural stony heart. Look at Ezekiel chapter 11. Ezekiel chapter 11. I'm reading here from verse 19. Ezekiel 11 verse 19. It says, and I will give them one heart, and I will put a new spirit within you, and I will take the stony heart out of their flesh, and will give them an heart of flesh. What a wonderful promise of sanctification. What a wonderful promise of inward holiness. What a wonderful promise of heart purification. It's a spiritual surgery that the Lord takes the knife of heaven and he cuts off that stubborn, stony heart from your flesh. If you are not sanctified, you don't have a pure heart, you don't have a holy heart, on the inside you are rebellious. If you die in that condition, the man dies in rebellion. He dies in stubbornness. He stands in rigidity in evil. He dies in disobedience. No matter what they preach after you are gone, nobody can tell us about assurance of heaven. Who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord? Who will stand in his holy place? They that have clean hands, that's salvation, and a pure heart, that's sanctification. That's why the Lord is saying, he wants you to have this source of miracle, this foundation of miracle, that he will cleanse your heart, he will purify your heart, he will change your heart, he will sanctify you. Look at verse 20. That they may walk in my statutes and keep mine ordinances and do them, and they shall be my people and I will be their God. The removal of the stony natural heart. Acts of the Apostles chapter 7. I'm reading from verse 51. Acts chapter 7, and we're reading from verse 51. Look at what Stephen told the people. Ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Ghost. As your fathers did, so do ye. It's talking about people whose Adamic nature has not been dealt with. The natural stony heart has not been taken away. But the Lord is saying for you. I said he's saying for you. He will do that to you. Are you still there? Where are you there? Will he do it today? I said, will you allow him today? Number one is the removal of the natural stony heart. Number two is the replacement of the new submissive heart. it takes away something and it brings in something better. The replacement with the new submissive heart. You need that new heart. And it's the only way to get to heaven. If you don't have this new heart, you come to church in vain. If you don't have this new heart, you call upon the name of the Lord in vain. If you don't have this new heart, salvation cleanses you from the outward sinful life. Sanctification, inner holiness, heart purity takes away that Adamic nature and gives you a new submissive heart. Psalm 24, I'm reading from verse 3. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He that has clean hands. Are your hands clean? No fraud? No bribery? No corruption? No stealing of church money? No stealing of government money? No defiling or touching somebody's daughter? No adultery with somebody's husband, somebody's wife? Are you free from idols? Clean hands. And then he tells us in verse 4, and a pure heart. And a pure heart. He takes away the impure and then he gives you the pure heart. And in Psalm 51, I'm reading here from verse 10. Psalm 51 verse 10. It tells us the prayer of that great man of God. The prayer you should pray for yourself today. I'm reading from Psalm 51 verse 10. Cleanse and create in me a clean heart, O God. And renew a right spirit within me. A clean heart. A clean heart. Remove the old one and give me something new. And then he will wash you whiter than snow. It says in verse 12. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. Uphold me with thy free spirit. Pure heart, it will happen. I said it will happen. Because God is still on the throne. Because the Lord is still in the business of saving souls and cleansing and sanctifying those who are saved today. Matthew chapter 5, I'm reading from verse 8. Matthew chapter 5, verse 8. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see the Lord. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see the Lord. How does that happen? You come to the Lord. You consecrate yourself afresh to the Lord. You lay everything on the altar without reservation. Lord, I give myself to you. Lord, I give my heart to you. I thank you I am saved. I thank you I'm born again. I thank you I have eternal life. I want something deeper. I want something greater. I want something higher. I want you to sanctify me. And I lay everything on the altar with that entire consecration. Comes entire sanctification. Acts of the Apostles chapter 15. And I'm reading here from verse 9. Acts of the Apostles chapter 15. And we're reading from verse 9. It says, and put no difference between us and them, purifying their hearts by faith. purifying their hearts by faith. Number one, there is the removal of the natural stony heart. Number two, there is the replacement with the new submissive heart. Number three, there is the realization of the new sanctified heart. A real experience, a definite experience, a practical experience, a present day and present life experience, that he circumcises your heart, he purifies your heart, and you come to that realization. Deuteronomy chapter 30, I'm reading from verse 6. Deuteronomy chapter 30, we're looking at verse 6. In verse 6, look at what it says. It tells us in verse 6, and the Lord thy God will circumcise thine heart. It's the work of the Lord. If you reject it, you are rejecting the Lord. If you resist it, you are resisting the Lord. If you turn away from sanctification, you are turning away from the Lord. He says, I want to sanctify you. I want to purify you. I want to cleanse you on the inside. And you say, all you want is religion. I don't want the righteousness of the heart. You reject the Lord, and he will reject you. But he says, you come and you commit yourself to the Lord, and you consecrate yourself to the Lord, and the Lord thy God will circumcise thine heart and the heart of thy seed to love the Lord thy God with all thine heart and with all thy soul and with all that thou mayest live. And that's the realization of a new sanctified heart. Jeremiah chapter 32. In Jeremiah chapter 32, I'm reading from verse 39. Jeremiah chapter 32, reading from verse 39. It tells us, and I will give you a new heart, one heart, and one way, that they may fear me forever. And you see what the Lord is saying? He says, when he sanctifies you, you honor him, you reverence him, every time, anytime, anywhere, forever. There are people who cannot live a straightforward life. Once the pastor turns his back, they are not looking at me, they begin to misbehave. They are not trustworthy. They are not faithful. They are not sanctified. They are religious. They are not purely righteous. But the Lord says, I want to do something. I want to sanctify you. I want to give you one heart and one way, that they may fear me forever, that for the good of them and not their children after them. Now it says in verse 40, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them, that I will not turn away from them to do them good, but I will put my fear in their hearts, that they shall not depart from me. You see what the Lord has said over there. Number one, he says, I'll remove the stony heart. Number two, I'll replace that with a submissive heart. Number three, I'll make you realize a sanctified heart. The purity through sanctification. There are three pillars of the Christian life. Number one is the salvation. Number two is the sanctification. Number three, the third pillar, is the baptism in the Holy Ghost. Immersion in the Holy Ghost. Outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Saturation by the Holy Ghost. For you shall receive power. After that, the Spirit has come upon you. And you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and Judea, and in Samaria, and to the uttermost part of the earth. We'll come back to Ezekiel chapter 36. Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 25, the salvation. Verse 26, the sanctification. Verse 27, that's the baptism in the Holy Ghost. Look at verse 27. And I will put my Spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes. And you shall keep my judgments and do them. The pouring out of the Spirit. And the Lord is saying, you must pray for this. You must ask him for this. You must plead for this. You must beseech the throne of grace for this. That he'll pour the Spirit upon your life. Look at verse 37. In verse 37, thus says the Lord God, I will yet for this be inquired of by the house of Israel to do it for them. And I will increase them with men like a flock. It says, I want to save you, but you must ask me. I want to sanctify you, but you must ask me. I want to fill you, baptize you with the Holy Ghost, but you must ask me. You see what the Lord is telling us here? Number one, the fullness of power through the Spirit. The fullness of power through the Spirit. That's what verse 27 is saying. I'll pour my Spirit upon you. I'll fill you with the Holy Ghost, the third personality in the Trinity. He'll saturate your life. He will envelope your life. He will surround your life. He will empower your life. He will energize your life. Fullness of power through the Spirit. Micah chapter 3. Micah chapter 3 verse 8. But truly, I am full of power by the Spirit of the Lord. Certainly, I am full of power by the Spirit of the Lord. Undoubtedly, unmistakably, I am full of power by the Spirit of the Lord. This he wants to do for you. He wants the power of heaven to be resident within you. He wants the power of the Holy Ghost to be inside you. And then you'll feel strong. You'll feel courageous. You'll have great faith in God. And the resident Holy Ghost in you will do the undoable and the seemingly impossible in your life. Truly, I'm full of power by the Spirit of the Lord. Luke chapter 24 verse 49. In Luke chapter 24 verse 49. And behold, I send the promise of the Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. Until ye be enveloped with power from on high. Until ye be saturated with power from on high. The fullness of power through the Spirit. That's what the early church waited on in the upper room. They were waiting for power. Saved, sanctified, baptized in the Holy Ghost. It was a church full of power. Your own time has come. I said your own time has come. Power of the Holy Ghost. The power of the Spirit. Saved and sanctified. That power will come upon your life. Am I talking to somebody there today? Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 8. Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 8. But ye shall receive a power. Who is that one talking about? I said, who is this talking about? But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. That's okay, but Nasarawa State. Uttermost part of the earth. I said it's talking about Nasarawa State. Far away from Jerusalem, the power that fell in Jerusalem, and then came to Judea, and then came to Samaria. Praise the Lord at my own time. Praise the Lord in the place where I am. Praise the Lord at your own time. And praise the Lord in the place where you are there. Power. Shout power. It is coming in Jesus' name. The fullness of power through the Spirit. The freedom in preaching by the Spirit. Power comes, then you become a preacher. Because the great commission has been given to the whole church. And Jesus told the whole church, go ye to all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. But many Christians today, no power, no courage, no conviction, no passion, no desire. They don't want to see other people saved. Me all the time. Give me this. They don't have any power. They finish one meeting today, and then the following week they want another thing tomorrow. I want this. They feel weak all the time. Saved, sanctified, baptized in the Holy Ghost, the fullness of power through the Spirit, and the freedom in preaching by the Spirit. Acts of the Apostles chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 1. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were assembled, where they were sitting. And it says, and there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And then Peter, that was a coward a few days before, in verse 14, but Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and said unto them, ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell in Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken unto my words. and he preached the word with freedom. Look at verse 31. And verse 31 of chapter 4. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 4, verse 31. And when they had prayed, the place was shaking where they were gathered together. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. It's coming upon your life. Somebody that said it's coming upon your life. And they spake the word.
Begin to pray for yourself. Has the message touched you in one way or the other? Just talk to God and pour out your heart to Him concerning the message that you've heard. Now believe the Lord God has spoken to each and every one of us. We've heard about the provision of salvation. Are you born again? Are you saved? Ask Him and say, Lord, here I come. Cleanse me and purify me. I need a salvation. Or is your salvation shaking? Say, Lord, restore unto me the joy of my salvation. Have you been born again but no sanctification? Ask the Lord God, sanctify me. Say, Lord, take away every stone in heart and give me the heart of flesh, a new heart. A heart that will please you. A heart that will be wholly yours. A heart that will be fully dedicated to your service. A heart that will be obedient to your commandments. A receptive heart. The Lord said in the book of Ezekiel, I will give you a new heart and I will take away the heart of stone. Say, Lord, give me a new heart. Give me a new heart. Begin to pray that the Lord God will give you a pure heart. Say, Lord, I want to experience it. That sanctification. The sanctification from on high. Say, Lord, take away that rebellious heart. That heart that is full of evil thoughts. The heart of stubbornness. The heart that manufactures evil. Say, Lord, take it away from me. A pure heart, and that's what I long for. A heart that follows on after you. Our heart has not divided, so that sin may not go in. Our heart and have compassion, our heart and rule serene. Yet though heart are full of righteousness, so that sin may not go in. Begin to pray, Lord, give me the pure heart. That is all I need. I want to experience a regeneration. Pray and say, Lord, help me to cleave to you, that I might be able to retain the salvation in the sanctification that you have given unto me. Lord, the power to cleave to you in order to keep the new heart that you have given unto me. I need a single heart, a one heart that is yours, that is 100% yours. That I will cleave unto you only as the author and the finisher of my faith. Say, Lord, I want to cleave to you. The grace, the strength to cleave unto you, so that I will not go back to my old ways, so that I will not go back to my old vomit, so that I will not go back to the sins in which you have set me free. Say, Lord, today I cleave unto you. Lord, I cleave unto you. Lord, I cleave unto you. Say, Lord, take my hands. I surrender all unto you. I surrender my will unto you. That thing that I have made first, that thing that I have been putting forth before you, say, Lord, today I surrender that idol. I surrender everything. Take the steering of my life. Be the driver of my life. Be the chairman over my affairs. Say, Lord, I've come to realize that I have no part of mine. That all that I have ever needed is in you, Jesus. Say, Lord,
counselors are waiting for you. Hurry up and finish your work. Church, keep on praying. Say, Lord, we need that sanctification today. We need the power of the Holy Ghost today. Saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. Counselors are waiting for you. Tell the Lord over there, but you must really desire, that sanctification. Remember, without holiness no man shall see the Lord. Remember, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see the Lord. Remember, he's coming for saints. He's not coming for secret sinners. Saints. When the saints go marching in, count me among the number, I will be there. Tell the Lord, so that your worshiping will not be in vain. On the day when the Lord shall come, you will be a saint, sanctified, purified, made holy. You will do it. This is the time. Let him do it for you. Sanctified, purified, made holy. He will do it. Counselors are waiting. Hurry up. In Jesus' name, and everybody shout. Now, counselors, hold on. Counselors, hold on. After the prayer, you can continue what you're doing. You're sick, you have any challenge, you have anything, you're asking the Lord. And you're saying, Lord, here is what I want. You raise up your hand wherever you are. Counselors, no counseling now. We're praying for the people. You raise up your hand wherever you are. Whatever miracle, whatever healing, whatever deliverance, the Lord is going to do it right now. Are you ready? Give me a good answer from Nasarawa State. Do you believe the Lord will perform the miracle right now? Raise up that hand. Lay the other hand on yourself. After the final amen, that healing will be there. That miracle will be there. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you at this time. We bless your name because you will never fail. And your power will, and your promise will never fail. I bring all your people before you. I'm asking, Lord, you touch everyone. Set is free and free indeed, free today and free forever. Lord, I pray any infirmity, insanity, madness there, I command, come out in Jesus' name. Any attack, affliction of the evil spirit there, I command, come out in Jesus' name. And any incurable disease there, be healed in Jesus' name. That swelling in your body, I command the swelling, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have an incurable disease, touch them now, cure them, heal them, deliver them in Jesus' name. I command those blind eyes be opened in Jesus' name. Paralysis and stroke, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. Having stroke, having paralysis, the strength of the Lord, come upon your body right now, rise up and walk in Jesus' name. And for those who are deaf and dumb, I pray you touch their ears and touch their vocal cords. They will hear. They will speak in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray you manifest yourself right now. Healing everywhere. Deliverance everywhere. Your wonders everywhere. Roll mountains away everywhere. Miracle everywhere. To the left, to the right, to the front, to the back, everywhere. Miracle in Jesus' name. Confirm it upon every life. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. It is done. It's done. I said it is done. Check up yourself. Those who are counseling, just wait where you are. Our pastor will come and give you instruction. Check up the power and the blessing of salvation he has given you. It will be visible in your life in Jesus' name. Sanctification visible in Jesus' name. And the power of the Holy Ghost baptism will be realizable, practical in your life in Jesus' name. God bless you. Our state pastor will take over now.
Praise the Lord! Multiple miracles. The mighty power of God has been released through the preaching and the prayer of the man of God. Check yourself. The power of God has touched you. You are healed already. Whatsoever you couldn't do before, get up now and begin to do it. Open your eyes now. Begin to see. The Lord has touched your blind eyes. You are healed. And you couldn't walk before, rise up. Begin to walk now. If you brought anyone that has been deaf before, check them up. The power of God has touched them. They are healed. They are delivered. Counselors, let's continue quickly. Attend to all who are here. And as you see the miracle power of God demonstrated in your life, you shout, hallelujah, so we can rejoice with you. Shout hallelujah there. God has done it. Miracle there. Healing there. Deliverance there. The mighty God of God has, power of God has touched you. Counselors, those who came out to give their lives to Christ, wait until you are given the sleep to feel. We want you to have the form, feel it, submit to the counselors, then you are free to go back to your seat. But if you have not been attended to, please stay where you are. And as you see the miracle power of God, God has touched you, God has healed you, you see the demonstration of the miracle power of God in your life, we want you to shout hallelujah. Then you come out here, we want to hear your testimony. We want to know the
and God will continue to bless the church in the name of Jesus Christ. For all of us that we bring our building offering, please let us raise it up because our time has gone. Let's quickly raise it up. Any building offering, in Jesus' name we pray. Our mighty Father, we thank you, Lord, because you have fed us physically. You have fed us spiritually. Oh, mighty Father, we glorify you only because of everything you are doing. Continue to be with us in Jesus' name. And let your grace continue to be upon us. Let the church be able to use this money for the glorification of your name. And provide for us all what we need, especially the car, the building. Let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answer prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I announced that because of Brother Benjamin, we are going out. Then because of our visitors. But now that Brother Benjamin is going to work, can we postpone it to next Sunday? Or what do we feel? Oh, wait. Our pastor, eh? What do we think? Maybe I can be clear. Okay. Please, Dad, let's propose it to lesson when it's going to be there. Yeah. Because of his birthday, then because I know I want to be seeing my sister. Are you promising me you are going to be here on Sunday? God will help you. But what about next Sunday? Next Sunday. Yes. Also, please, I would like to say, and the God is going to help us in Jesus' name. If there's another thing I mentioned yesterday, I was mentioning food pantry. Then I saw that Sister Priscilla was looking. He was saying something. Now I get home. I saw that there's a difference between food pantry and food bank. So, please, it is food bank we have, not food pantry.
So please, and then you know that thing they call t-shirt, they put t-shirt there, just go into the fridge. Only that Stephen should not go to my fridge because we eat the same local food. So just go to the fridge, take anything you want, anything that belongs to us. Until we're able to separate it, we are going to separate it. But take anything you want, put it inside the bag and take it. If you have somebody you need to give, if you don't take it, we won't know how to preserve this thing, how to work on it. And God has been providing for us. So all of us need to work on it and see how we are going to be preserving that food. What do we say? It doesn't mean I don't need it. It's spoiled. And we are using it, but not the way we're supposed to be using it. When you see the fridge is full. So please, look at the fridge. Look at whatever you need. Take it. If there's any suggestion you have, let us know. Then we will do it. I think that is all. I'm very sorry. I don't know that Brother Benjamin is going to work today. So please, on Sunday, we are going to go together to celebrate, and then with my sister in Jesus' name. It's our culture that anytime we have a visitor, we go out together. But we want it to be one so that... praise the Lord. God bless you. Eh? You are going to Chicago on Sunday? Okay. Okay, we look at what we are going to do. God is going to bless. When are you coming back, man? You come back Sunday. Okay, so you've been in the Asfellowship. I mean, Asfellowship on Sunday. Okay.
No, in the evening.
In the evening. Okay. Okay. It is well. It is well. Praise the Lord. Brother Stephen can quickly see me later. Before you leave.